Where the fuck's the dining room? Finley's probably the worst. Elsa, are you serious? You don't remember our first rehearsal. They're still talking about this shit. No, I don't. But I do remember you and Sophie switching out the prop bourbon for actual and drinking the entire bottle live. Oh, I did no such thing. Paige, pass the sugar, please. Sure. Oh, ho, ho. Yes, you did. Then why don't I remember it? Because you drank the entire bottle, sweetheart. Come on now. Only half? So you do remember. Either way, we got banned from putting on plays after that. I'm pretty sure we only got banned from putting on ones not on the pre-approved list. What's so great about all those old plays, anyway? Would you all speak up? Would you all
besides
be interested
the, 21st century version of Romeo and Juliet? Nothing.
With Leonardo DiCaprio?
Yes, that one.
It's so fucked up in so many ways. It's so great. Just guns and shit, and you're like, what?
Dost thou bite thy thumb to me? So and they pull out a gun. Gonna cap a bitch.
Gonna cap a bitch. What the fuck is this shit? Would you all be interested in playing one of our old improv games? I don't.
I told you to call her a liar. You told her she was a storyteller.
Great idea. Wait. Are you sure? What? You scared of a little quick thinking, Margot? Margot used to be the best at improv. It's not that. I thought we're not supposed to talk about... What are we not supposed to talk about, ladies?
Talk about what?
If you think it's alright, I'll play. Really? I guess. I guess I'll play too, then. Should we wait for Finley? There it is.
Oh, yeah.
There it is. She'll probably show up once the game is over in classic Finley fashion. Which one did you want to play, Paige? Just the one where we go in a circle saying the next part of a story? Sounds good to me. You want to start? Oh.
Oh, this no. is gonna...
You
this
go
is,
first.
This is,
I insist. Here we go, then. Classic fashion, here we go.
Okay. Another little game, then.
So the story starts like this.
You had to tell her she was a storyteller.
Shut up. Something like this could never happen. The princess thought... The princess
You're gonna... Of course you are.
And she...
And she took a huge yes. Continue.
Alright, it's time to leave.
Is this...
Bite of an apple. That just sounds... Ugh. The princess wasn't a jealous person. Sometimes she envied... Why is it so loud?
Why'd she envy cows?
I don't know. It's my turn, right?
Mm-hmm.
So, even if it did happen, her village had the strongest walls, her kingdom had the largest army, her prince would protect her. Okay, so we're going to go with strongest walls or largest army.
You're not going to give her a prince.
What prince? Where? She's a lesbian.
How sexist of you.
Fuck off. It's got a large army. I like war. Surely, like, here comes the nurse. Good size is everything! That's what an army wants you to
turn
believe.
The volume down more.
Go ahead, Soph.
Okay, sound effect. There you go.
Go ahead, Sophie.
Thank you.
Thank you,
I appreciate you.
Guess I should figure out what this disaster is. Well, then. The princess could think whatever she liked.
I was
going to
say prince. That's a
shit, fuck off. The witch foretold a massive storm would destroy her kingdom, and the witch was never wrong. Does it have to be a storm? Elsa, don't interrupt. Ooh, disciplined by Paige. She does seem like the most fun. Oh, hush, Margo.
I want Margo in my life.
Continuing. We all need a Margo in our lives. The princess had to remain strong. For her diplomatic ties, for her subjects, for herself. Because no one else would be strong for her.
Exactly. You need to be a strong, independent woman.
With a large army. So that's just the curse of being a princess who's envied cows for some reason.
Like Elsa. Elsa's a strong, independent woman that needs nobody.
With a shotgun. great.
Well, not that Elsa.
Not that Elsa, the Ice Queen. Good. Good on you. Does the princess care or not that her kingdom is about to be blown to smithereens? Oh, here we go. Doesn't. Tries to. Does. I'm confused. I don't know if I can take this lady seriously. I think someone's trying to avoid the next line for the story. I thought you were good at thinking on your feet. Is someone getting a little old? Piffed like you're one to talk with that memory of yours. Oh, she does have weird fucked up memory then.
Mm.
Or should I say lack of? Oh, fine. We'll skip you for now. But you better be ready next round. The princess decided to try to have some fun. She had a cookout in the castle garden.
Okay.
She held a ball. She declared a new holiday.
Oh, the- you want to go to the garden. Of course, because where else would poison ivy be? In the fucking garden.
And she's having a cookout in the garden.
So food and a possible appearance of poison ivy.
Woo! Yeah. The princess ordered the royal griller. The royal
griller. Wouldn't that just be a chef?
Because this isn't that kind of story. Also, there's a burger on the screen now.
Where? Where's
the burger? Right here. Because I went apple, army, now food.
Yes.
Sweet potatoes, hamburgers, corn on the cow. Stop talking.
Food.
She even grilled the... Okay.
What?
She even grilled the Count of Gudoschnik on why he hadn't paid his taxes yet for this year.
I'm talking...
But no worries. What? The Count would be forgiven for this crime as long as he helped with the hot dogs.
Mm-hmm.
The fun made time fly. And before everyone knew it, it was time to go home. But as they did, gusting winds rocked the trees, clouds started rolling in, thunder roared in the distance. People laughed as the winds blew them around on their way home from the festivities. The children especially enjoyed leaning against the gusts to see if the wind would keep them upright. Fucking do it. Fucking fall flat on your faces. The whole village had sweet dreams that night. The burden of worry remained solely with the princess. Everything was as it should be. Your turn, Margot? Ugh. I don't know. Come on, Margot. Okay. I'll figure something else. And so...
This would be me.
So the storm hit. Yeah? Very good. Oh, that was riveting. Overnight, all of the princess's responsibilities washed away. When the sun rose for the first time ever, the princess was independent, the princess was free, or the princess was alone. Well, not that one. There was no one to cook for her, to read to her, nor paint her nails for her. How would she survive? The princess had a lot to figure out in her new world. Who could she become? Who was she? Who was she now? Sure. Before the princess would become a queen.
Mad Max style world.
But now is the princess destined to become nothing? Wow, guys. And then, it's starting to delve into their own. The princess decided eating was probably a good next step. It's always great. She went to the kitchen and searched the cupboards, the fridge, or the oven. But it was empty.
What?
What? Impossible. Well, minus ingredients, but ingredients aren't a meal. She didn't know what to do. Alright, I think I got this. The princess went to the castle library to look for a cookbook. She had never looked for a book before, but it felt good to do something herself for a change. Once she found a cookbook, she opened it to one of her favorite comfort foods. Pan-seared foie gras with spiced citrus puree.
What?
Spinach and... Nope. Escargot and garlic... So, snails and butter. I don't know what the fuck that is.
So, we're gonna go with that, aren't we?
Or spinach. So, we're gonna go with this.
Huh.
Wait a minute. Foie gras is force-fed duck liver. Great. Gross. The princess was appalled. How could something that...
She's so nice.
Tasted so nice. Be something so vile. Decision made... The princess would never eat foie gras again. She decided to make a souffle instead.
Oh, God.
They kind of sounded like a pain to make, but she wouldn't learn unless she tried, and she had never been allowed to try before. Take it away, Elsa. Elsa? Did you go get Finley? Yoo-hoo, Elsa! Huh?
She got bored.
Sorry, I spaced out there for a minute. It's your turn. For what? Oh, wow, she has terrible memory. We're playing a game, Elsa. I love games. Which one? Oh.
Okay.
Oh, no.
Go look at the flowers.
Oh, that was terrible. That was like a Mice and Men style. What are you doing, man?
That was a reference to fucking Walking Dead, you know? When Carol told the little girl to look at the flowers.
Just shut up.
Okay.
Just shut up. Okay. I know I'm not the best at noticing sarcasm or any of that, but are you joking or... Oh, there's the door. Finley! Finley's here! Fucking hell.
Saved by the bell.
It's about fucking time, I need to know. You gonna be okay, Pedro? Okay, what the hell was that about? This steak just keeps getting weirder and weirder. What do you mean? Well, Finley's about to fuck up this party. Earlier this morning, Elsa showed us a game she plays with her husband. They set traps around the house with a gun. A gun? A shotgun specifically, and they try to shoot each other with it.
What?
Well, you're not there for that part.
I zoned out, I'm sorry.
Yeah, they set traps when she had the shotgun.
Oh, yeah, that trap. Yeah.
Yeah, there you go. Are you sure it wasn't one of her old prop guns? Knowing us that she hasn't thrown away anything from her theater days, she probably doesn't remember shit. It looked pretty real to me. Did she fire it? No. Then I'm sure it's just a prop. This might sound strange, but because this is Elsa we're talking about, I'm more concerned with her memory loss. Paige, you talk to Elsa more than any of us. Do you know anything? You do, don't you?
She's hiding something.
Pedro.
She's keeping secrets.
Yes. But I'm not sure Elsa knows that I know. Yes, that would be a thing. You see?
Mm-hmm.
Elsa had a procedure done. A procedure like a surgery... No. Wait, when? Elsa and John's lovey-dovey vacation 2 years ago.
Okay.
Elsa wouldn't shut up about that trip. She called me almost every day leading up to it. Well, it wasn't a vacation. After they got married, Elsa told me she started having... problems. Okay.
Okay.
John took her to see a doctor. The doctor said she needed a procedure. So she got it done. I tried asking what for, but all she said was, and I only remember because it seemed so odd, the weather is so lovely today. It's difficult to focus on such a lovely day. I want to go for tea. And then we went for tea. I don't remember her recovering from any procedure. 2 years ago. 2 years ago is when Elsa stopped acting. I thought it was weird that John told us not to ask us about it. I'm sure they have their reasons every couple... I want to know, guys. Come on.
Yeah, come on.
Cut the fuck on. What happened to Elsa? What procedure are we talking about? And clearly it didn't work, because, Jesus.
She's not remembering shit.
Finley, come on. I need an appearance by Finley, and I needed to be spectacular. Come on, Finley. Slow down, Elsa. Faster, faster. I'm still jet-lagged. But everyone is waiting. Elsa's got some energy. Well, Elsa seems happy enough. Maybe we're making a bigger deal of it than it is. Ladies, may I present... This is gonna be great. The one and only Finley. Oh, fuck's sake, yes. Please be normal. Please be fucking normal.
She's not normal.
A normal lesbian.
Yeah, okay.
Howdy. Oh god, all of their expressions are changing. Hey, sorry for getting here so late. I'd be more concerned if you were on time, is the joke. How many places have you traveled to this time? Not that many, but my stays were longer than usual. Oh, Paige. Yes, the fabric looks good. It's your fabric.
Mm-hmm. Yes, your I fabric. Figured that out when they mentioned the fabric. I got that one.
I knew you'd put it to good. There it is. There's the confirmation. Mm-hmm. Thanks.
Okay. And silence.
Oh, that's funny. Either that was my stomach or I just heard thunder. Huh? I didn't hear anything. Oh, Sophie. Elsa told me about the good news. When are you due? Come on, come on, come on. It's time for shopping, sunshine, and fine dining. You didn't hear that. Maybe it was my stomach then. Fortunately, that problem can be sorted by eating lunch, for which we have reservations to do. Well, look at those clouds. Yeah, the storm's supposed to happen. Okay, I definitely either heard thunder or Sophie's stomach that time. Me too. Except I don't think it was Sophie's stomach.
But they have $50 a person if they don't show up.
You'd be surprised. The forecast...
That's $250. That's $250 if they don't go.
Calm down. Calm down. It'll be alright. Margo's got $250.
Okay. I'm good.
Sorry. Somebody call and cancel really quick, please. The forecast didn't say anything about a storm. I don't know what any of you are talking about. You're all just hearing and seeing things. No, Elsa. I don't think we are. Look. They looked at the window, I'm guessing.
Oh, yeah. She got sad.
Everything is flooding. I've never seen anything like this. I'm going to call the restaurant. Yeah. See, mm-hmm. There it is. mm-hmm. I'm sure they'll understand. No. Please don't. Someone must be pretty angry with us up there. You made a heaven joke. Nice. That means this is not my fault, isn't it? What did you...
What?
Huh? I'll say it was a joke. Because I thought I... Pretty sure that's not how storms work. Elsa, don't worry. We'll still have fun. Everything is going to be fixed.
She going through, like...
Please?
A crisis?
What did she do? Like, say on something?